अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, यस वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल लेट्स जॉइन फार्मेसी। यस टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट द पार्ट 3 इन योर फार्मास्यूटिकल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन। सी माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, दैट इज द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, 10 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन, इट इज अ फिक्स क्वेश्चन इन अवर एग्जामिनेशन, दैट इज एक्सप्लेन द प्रिंसिपल प्रोसीजर एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एनी वन थर्मल मेथड ऑफ स्टेरलाइजेशन। मीन्स बेसिकली देर आर 4 to 5 मेथड्स ऑफ स्टेरलाइजेशन। Okay, sterilization methods. Here, once they will ask, they ask about the hot air oven. See here, principal procedure and application sterilization using hot air oven. How can you sterilize by means of the hot air oven? Then sometimes they will ask, write any one type of the sterilization method. In that manner, they can ask. Particularly, they will ask the hot air oven only. Okay, hot air oven. Many more times they ask hot air one, but this time maybe they will ask filterization or moist method, physical method. Okay, methods are there, I will tell you. You got this? This question is fixed. Okay, proof means by means of this question papers. Yes, let's discuss. Before going to that, it is the chapter 2 question, sterilization. What is this sterilization, my dear brothers and sisters? Sterilization, it is the process that removes or kills or deactivates all form of the microorganisms like bacteria, fungi or viruses or spores. Clear? Got it? It is the sterilization. Means what we are doing means we are killing that or removing that or denaturing that proteins of that microorganism. Either it can be fungi, spore or any type of the bacteria. That process is known as sterilization. Now sterile means what? Means material that has been heated in such a way that it contains no living organism. Now see, for an example, water. We are taking water, just water I am telling. For water, we are using some of the thermal techniques to maintain the sterile in that. Okay, that maintaining sterile condition is known as sterile water. Today we are using in many medical fields, like in injection purpose, we are using sterile water only because they are free from spores or fungi or any type of the progenies. Now, next we discuss about the methods of sterilization. Yes, this is the very important concept. Here, I will not read about only one or two methods of sterilization because they ask only three methods of sterilization. One is about in moist heat sterilization, physical methods. In these two only, they selected some of the few. But my dear brothers and sisters, in 5 marks, there is a chance of asking the filtration also, radiation also, sound and ultrasonic vibrations also. So, my request to you all, you just glance these all 5. Today we will discuss about these two. One is physical methods and moist heat sterilization. Got it? First one is a physical method. Means the sterility. How can we maintain the sterile conditions of the material? By physical method. See here, one is dry heat sterilization. Dry heat sterilization. Just understand the concept. No need to buy hat. Just understand. What is sterilization means? It is a process where we maintaining the sterile conditions. Means where we maintaining the stop of the growth of microorganisms. Maybe bacteria, fungi. Just understand the concept. A dry heat sterilization. Drying has a wonderful effect on many bacteria. Okay, however, spores are unaffected and remains for several months. Here in dry heat sterilization, it is not a selected method, but because why it's not a selected, hum kyun iska istemal nahi karte, isliye kyunki ye spores ko kill nahi karta. It doesn't kill the spores or it doesn't inhibit the spores. Got it? And dry heat kills microorganisms by causing protein denaturation and destruction, oxidation of essential cell constituents. See here, microorganisms it will kill. Which one? This dry heat sterilization. Dry heat kills the microorganism by causing. How it kills? It will denature the protein. Means it will decreases the protein metabolism. It will decreases the size of the protein. That is protein denaturation, and it will destruct the oxidation of the cell. Got it? Then in this dry heat sterilization, there are various methods. One is sunlight. See here, sunlight means gradually ultraviolet rays. Direct sunlight has a sterilizing effect due to the presence of UV rays. It has a bactericidal effect and is one of the natural methods of sterilization of the water in rivers, lakes, tanks. Okay, direct falling of sunlight on the rivers, lakes or tanks, they will kill some of the microorganisms which were present on top of the water, on the river, oceans, lakes. It will make the water sterile for some condition. Tank water. Got it? Now, red hot. Red hot means inoculating wires, loops, forceps points and spatulas are sterilized by holding them on the flame of Bunsen burner. Now see, while using the equipments, we want to use the equipments in our chemical laboratories. There what we are doing means we are just keeping our red hot, means our Bunsen spatulas or forceps points, so loops, wires, which we want to use, no, that we are just keeping on the Bunsen flame, because to make that things, material, sterile, okay, sterile, free from all the microorganisms, we are using such type of the Bunsen flame. It is known as a red hot type of sterilization. Simple. Next is a flaming. See here, glass lights, flaming means glass lights, then mouth of culture tubes, cover slips, blades, or any glass item, any metal glass type of items, blades, they are sterilized by passing over them the flame of the Bunsen burner. Okay, flaming means on the Bunsen flame we are passing all these materials to kill the microorganisms. Simple. Now the next one is a hot air oven. See, a hot air oven, particularly they ask the question of hot air oven for two times they have asked in previous year question papers. You just understand the basic concept in hot air oven. In upcoming, in next class only, we will discuss a detail about the hot air oven. Okay, 10 marks question, it is a fixed question. So, hum iska mauke ka fayda utha ke isko dhyan se padhenge aur 10 marks easily hum isme score karenge. इसलिए दोस्तों कल का वीडियो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट है. हॉट एयर ओवन, इट इज मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड मेथड ऑफ स्टरलाइजेशन बाय ड्राई हीट. बेहतरीन ड्राई हीट मेथड अगर हम सब चुनेंगे तो इट इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट. हियर द सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच आर नॉट डिग्रेडेड बाय हीट आर सेट अप टू स्टरलाइज एट 250 डिग्री सेल्सियस बाय हॉट एयर ओवन. ओके, द सब्सटेंसेज विच आर नॉट डिग्रेडेड, विच आर नॉट किल्ड बाय द हीट मीन्स, और दे आर नॉट स्टरलाइज बाय द हीट मीन्स, we are sterilized them at 250 degree Celsius by hot air oven. Hot air oven, okay. Normally at temperature of 160 for 2 hours. How the procedure means, first for any material, now any glass material you take or any type of the metal you take, that is the material which should be sterilized. First 2 hours heat for 160, then spores as well as the small microorganisms will die for 160 degrees for 2 hours. Then it is ideal method of sterilization of the glassware, surgical equipment, swab, sticks, many type, okay, of the materials we can sterilize them by this hot air oven. Then the sterilization temperature and holding time for sterilization in the hot air oven is 3 hours at 140 degrees Celsius. We have to maintain consistency 3 hours of time at 140 degrees Celsius. Then after that 1 hour at 160 degrees. Then 30 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. Got it? The first one is a sterilization control of hot air oven. Generally, there are two methods to control. Means if the hot air oven or the sterilization exceeds beyond, means how can we control that? One is chemical control, second one is biological control. See here, what is this chemical control? Brownie's tube containing red solution is placed with the oven. Got it? A green color is produced after 60 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius, which indicates a proper sterilization by dry heat method. How can we know that the sterilization is proper? Means here what we are doing means just Brownian's tube containing a red solution, that should contain the red solution, we have to place that into the oven, that is hot air oven. Then after some time or after with the reaching the temperature of 160 degrees Celsius, there will be appearance of green color. That indicates that sterilization is complete of hot air oven or dry heat by dry heat. Then biological control. It is the second type of the control. An envelope containing a filter paper strip inoculated with 10 spores of bacillus then bacillus subtilis is placed with the ovum. Okay, 10 spores of bacillus subtilis is we have to place that in the ovum. Then ovum after sterilization process. Okay, the strip is removed and inoculated into the trapped-tone soy broth and inoculated. That should be incubated, means kept for 37 degree for 5 days under aerobic condition. Means there should be presence of oxygen. Absence of bacillus subtilis indicated. If there is absence of bacillus subtilis, means a sterilization of dry it is perfect. What we have to do means it is a procedure. How can we control? How can we control the biological control of the spores, or how can we maintain the sterility? Means see here, first what we have to do, we have to take 10 spores of bacillus subtilis. Okay, then we have to keep after sterilization process, the strip is removed. We have to remove that strip. We have to remove the strip, and that should be inoculated in trapped-tone soy broth. After inoculating that strip, where into the trapped-tone soy broth. Broth means a liquid solution, a culture. Then we have to incubate, or we have to heat them for 37 degrees Celsius for 5 days. If there is a no growth of organism, means there we have to think that the sterilization is in a perfect way by means of dry heat method. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters. Next is moist heat. Okay, that's about we discuss about the hot air oven. Now moist heat, it is the second type of the sterilization method. Sterilization by moist heat implies killing the microorganism with a steam or hot water. How can we kill the microorganism? Means by means of steam, just a steam. Now cooker steam, while you cook the rice, means what the steam is coming out, no? Huh, that's a type of the steam. It is also a method of sterilization, or hot water. Hot water. Now moist heat kill the microorganism by denaturation and coagulation of the proteins. Yes, moist heat is sterilization in the three temperature. One is a temperature at below 100 degree, then at 100 degree exact, above 100 degree Celsius. Yes, temperature below 100 degree, vaccine bath. Bacterial wax vaccines are sterilized by a special water bath called vaccine bath at 60 degree for 1 hour, which kills most vegetative bacteria. Many type of the smaller bacteria are killed where at the temperature of the 60 degree Celsius for 1 hour. Okay, then pasteurization. Here you have studied in our lower classes pasteurization process. Means here the process, it is used for the milk. First what we are doing, we are heating the milk and just we are cooling that immediately. Okay, there it is a type of the method of moist heat method. Okay, here temperature below 100 degree, we are heating and just we are cooling that milk. It is a pasteurization technique. Today what we are getting, Nandini milk, Arogya milk, that all milks are by means of pasteurization. They will, because this pasteurization process will kills the microorganism, it will make the milk sterile. Got it. Temperature 100 degree. Boiling at 100 degree or 70 to 80 degree can kill many vegetative bacteria, fungi and viruses at 100 degree, exact 100 degree. Okay, this is the second type. Yes, now the steam at 100 degree for 90 minutes. 100 degree steam, not hot water, steam. Sugar media which may decompose while boiling can be steam at 100 degree for 90 minutes. This leads to kill many microorganisms. Okay, sugar media which can be decomposed while boiling. Sugar. Okay, yes, gradually if you add water to that sugar, means it will decompose, it will turns into the liquid. So just we are passing the steam to that sugar so that it can be removed, or it can be killed, or it can be inhibited the many type of the microorganisms. Okay, steam type of method. Then temperature above 100 degree. When water boils in a closed and airtight container under increased pressure, the temperature of the steam inside rises above 100 degree. Okay, which effectively destroy both vegetative cells and the heat spores. It is one of the better method, but dangerous also. Okay, what is the boiling temperature of water? 100 degree Celsius. Here we have to maintain above 100 degree. How means water boil? It should be boiled in the closed container and airtight container under increased pressure. Pressure should be increased. The temperature of the steam inside rises above 100 degree, which effectively describes the different types of the microorganism, maybe spores of the microorganisms, maybe the proteins of the microorganisms, every particle get destroyed by means of this above 100 degrees Celsius, my dear brothers and sisters. Yes, these are the two methods. Today we studied about the two methods of sterilization, that is, one is of a physical and moist heat method. In next class, we will discuss about the one more very important, the special method, that is hot air oven. Here we discuss just basic thing. In next coming classes, we will discuss about the hot air oven. One is the very, 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 very important, infinite important question for 10 marks. So wait for that 10 marks for next class, and be joined to my WhatsApp group if you are new. And if you are new to the channel, subscribe my channel, Let's Join Pharmacy. Thank you. Assalam.